ipaglaban mo since this is their second anniversary and you are part of their kumbaga episode to celebrate that anniversary. Yeah. So how does it feel?
Of course I'm honored. Pasalamat kay Direk Ruel for including me in the anniversary of ipaglaban mo. And in fact, parang they gave me a podcast. It's a remake. Eh. Mm-hmm. Parang it's a remake of one of their most popular episodes.
Wow.
And in fact, the original of mine, I think, is E.J. Falcon. So, nakakatawa na I have an opportunity to portray one of their best episodes again. And the story was very, you know, the story is very compelling. Mm-hmm. It was a very intense 2 days. But I was happy to have, you know, done it with Direk Lino Cayetano. And I was happy to have done Ipaglaban Mo for the first time.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
First time ko
tapos they saved it for the anniversary. So maraming salamat Direk Ruel ma'am for that.
Tell us more about the story.
So ano siya, parang hardinero siya. Tapos sa kanya parang frename siya for killing the whole family. It's mm-hmm. very intense episode sobra. So pagkatapos nun, parang pinilit siyang aminin sa court na siya talagang gumawa ng police. So I don't wanna spoil it too much, even though nare-remake to, pero ganun kabigat yung tema this Saturday. So, hopefully you guys can watch. But, you know, not for anything, meron rin good side, kasi tumulong rin naman sa kanya ay police din. Napatunayan na innocent siya. So, may bali naman. May bali naman, which kind of works with today's, with what's happening with today's everything. Because everything is really wild. I see the news and so many things are happening and pero no offense naman to the police, but yun na nga, there's a good side to it as well. Na yung tumulong rin sa kanya at nagpatunay na inosyente sa ng police.
Is there anything na dito sa Ipaglaban Mo episode na na-challenge ka?
Wow, again, it was a physically exhausting episode kasi parang tinorture siya, then pumunta sa courtroom, and then he was, you know, like, it was not being able to express that he's innocent kasi nga, diba, nandun yung police.
Oh, kasi kailangan mo ka siyang
shame. Wow, it was a very exhausting, physically grueling episode, pero it was fun kasi I got to work with Direk Lino Cayetano again. And saka the episode revolves around me. So all the scenes were just me.
Yes.
It's not like I had too many people to help me through the scenes. And maybe in the beginning, si Diego was there in the beginning, pero all throughout parang mag-isa ako eh. So I wasn't drawing any emotions for someone else.
Yeah.
It was just for me. So like, jump into the scene by yourself and be emotional. So it's more difficult that way. Sometimes madali when you have someone to interact with or something.
Lessons learned while portraying your character.
Lessons learned. I don't think man there was much of a lesson learned, but at least, siguro the reality, at least truth will set you free, no matter how long the judicial system takes here, but nakalaya siya. So even with that, parang there's always hope. There's faith, and
there's
he was
hope.
Able to clean his name for something that he wasn't able to do. So that lalabas at lalabas din yung totoo. I guess that's the moral lesson of this episode.
Sino-sino ang iba pang artista ang makakasama mo dito?
This is the first time I work with a lot of the people. Eh. Even si Diego Luisaga, first time. I'm sorry if I'm not familiar with the names, but yeah, Junjun Quintana, Suzette Ramillo, Lorenzo Mara, and also like, yeah, this person I worked with before in the soap with me, Isa, and Andy, Mark Stopasio is in. So, yeah, it's a good cast, pero like I said, like, naka-excel ako lahat na ng kapiraso, but it was all just me. It was more me, Direk Lino, working the whole time.